Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will discuss in detail the Karnataka budget 2018-19. So we are arriving at the end of the current financial year 2018, and now financial year 2019 will begin on 1st of April 2018. So that is what we call the financial year 2019, which will start in more than a month from now. Siddaramaiah, well, he is facing crucial elections in 2 months' time. So everybody was expecting this to be a, you know, please for all budget, and this was exactly that. So he has tried to keep everyone happy, and I will bring the analysis. My name is Gaurav. This video will be in English language. StudyIQ has launched a lot of pen drive courses for UPSC, SSC, Bank PO, and a lot of other exams. If you believe you want to prepare using any paid course, then do check out the website studyiq.com. All of these are paid courses, but we do have plenty of free material also. And we also have test series for UPSC. So do check out studyiq.com. Do connect with me on Instagram. My ID is tirelesssoul. Or you can follow me on Twitter. My ID is gauravgarg888. Now, before I start the video, Siddaramaiah was very happy. And of course, every Kannadiga or from Karnataka, whoever the person is, should be happy because they have had a very favorable verdict, Kaveri verdict from the Supreme Court. They have got some extra water. And you know that there was a Kaveri tribunal, but none of the two states, they wanted to obey the tribunal. So they took the matter in the Supreme Court, and Karnataka has got extra water. So no wonder Siddaramaiah was happy, and he tweeted that he is very happy. It has given a relief of 14.75 TMC, which includes an additional quantity of 4.75 TMC for Bengaluru. Moving on. So Karnataka Chief Minister has presented 12 budgets before this. This was his 13th budget. So, I mean, very, very vastly experienced. And this was his 6th budget as a Chief Minister. And five budgets he has presented as Chief Minister till now. So this was his 13th budget. Now, looking at some important data. So the GDP of Karnataka grew in 2017-18 at 8.5%. This is projected. Of course, we are still not done with the year. It will end on 31st March 2018. So, but the projection is 8.5%. This is more than the last year. Last year, it was only 7.5%. So, the state GDP grew by more than 1 percentage point compared to last year. Or you can say 100 basis points. Now, in this year, 2017-18, which is ending on 31st March, agriculture sector is expected to grow by 4.9%. Industry sector, again 4.9%. The service sector is expected to grow at 10.4%. The total budget was 2,09,181 crore rupees, and this was 12.12% more compared to the budget estimate of last year. And the fiscal deficit is projected at 2.49% in the coming financial year, which is below the 3% recommended by the FRBM Act and also the Karnataka Fiscal Responsibility Act. This does not apply to only Karnataka but to all the states. The fiscal deficit of the state should not be more than 3% of the state GDP. That is a general rule. So, let's see what are the initiatives in the digital foray. So, first is eShan. It is launched to issue caste, income and residence certificate online. The portal will be called eShana. There is an app called Maulya app, which is launched to know the guidance value of any immovable property. Mulya, right? Mulya basically means worth. What is your worth? Then development of Samyojan app to obtain citizen services of the department. The app is called Samyojan. Now, please note that I'm not from Karnataka. So my pronunciation might be a little different to what you are used to hearing. So do forgive me for that. Development of Dishank app. Now, Dishank app is to obtain survey number and map of the spot where citizens stand. This is called Dishank app. These are the four important apps that will be launched. Also, one very important scheme is the Mukhya Mantri Anil Bhagya. It will benefit 30 lakh people, and it is a concrete step towards smoke-free Karnataka as per the Chief Minister. And this will benefit 30 lakh people at a cost of 1350 crore rupees. In this, gas connection along with two burner gas stove will be provided, and there will be two refill cylinder also that will be provided free of cost. Then government of Karnataka has accepted the, you know, 6th pay commission recommendation, and the 6th pay commission will be implemented from the first day of the new financial year 2019, that is from 1st of April 2018. Students across Karnataka will be provided free bus pass from the new financial year that is approaching, and this will help them in education. This will also remove all the deterrent. This will benefit around 20 lakh students. So 19.6 lakh students of Karnataka will benefit from the free bus passes. Now, before I move further, before I explain to you education, healthcare, you should know what is primary education, what is secondary education, what is tertiary education, and so on. So primary education is from grade 1 to grade 8, okay, or you can say from age of 6 to 14. Secondary education is from grade 9 to 12, that is 9, 10th, 11th and 12th class. Then you have tertiary education, which is 12th class onwards. So now let's take a look at the education in detail. So primary and secondary education has got allocation of 22,350 crore rupees. This is one of the highest amount you will see in any state for education, for primary and secondary. Please note, this is only for primary secondary, okay? Higher education is different. So there will be 176 integrated school in every Gram Panchayat center. They have been opened already to enhance the quality of education in government schools up to 12th standard under one roof. And this will be continued in the coming financial year. Also, 100 more schools. So 176 already they have opened. Okay, that is what they are claiming. Now 100 more they will open in the coming financial year. So these are integrated Karnataka public school will be opened at 5 lakh rupees per school. And therefore 100 into 5, that is 5 crore rupees. And also it is intended to start Bharat Scout and Guide unit in this school to infuse a sense of universal brotherhood and all those cultural values and blah blah. Now, safety of children, CCTV cameras and all this will be put in the schools. Also, in commemoration of the centenary, that means 100 years of state central library, the district, city and taluk library will be upgraded as digital library. Also, for the first time, through cloud computing, it is intended to provide digital library facility to 10 lakh students studying in the government high school and the government pre-university colleges. For that, a 5 crore rupees sum has been allocated. Now, it is also proposed to give one Atyuttama SDMC award in each taluk to the best performing school development and management committee at the government primary and high school level. The award is called Atyuttama SDMC award, which is will be given to the best performing school department. And 100 primary and high school which have completed 100 year will be recognized as heritage schools. So in Karnataka, all those schools which have completed 100 year, 100 of those will be declared heritage schools. They will be renovated and they will be protected. So to develop the scientific attitude of high school children, it is intended to start science committee at all the high school and pre-university colleges. And also mobile science laboratory will be established in all the districts in collaboration with Agastya Foundation. The outlay for that is 7.5 crore rupees. Now there will be science committee in every high school and pre-university college. There will be mobile science laboratory in all the districts. Also, total amount you should mug up, as I told you earlier also, 22350 crore. Now let's talk about higher education. So for higher education, we have the amount 4514 crore, that is almost one fourth of what is for primary and secondary education. So to facilitate the propagation and further study of the thoughts of Kranti Yogi Sri Baswanna. So who was this fellow? He was a 12th century philosopher belonging to the Lingayat sect, Basavanna. So a herald of social equality, you know, he introduced parliamentary system for the first time to the world. A grant of 2 crore rupees will be provided to establish Basava Study Center at Mysuru University in Mysore. Is it clear? At Mysuru University, there will be Basava Study Center to propagate the teachings of Yogi Sri Basavanna. To achieve further education in higher education in the state, there is 1 crore rupees will be spent for establishing postgraduate center at Chikmagaluru under the Kuvempu University. And there will be a postgraduate center at Jamakandi of Bagalkot under the Rani Chiramma University. Also, to encourage large number of women getting education in post-graduation, an exemption from payment of full fee will be provided to all the girl students. This is very, very new. Girl students don't have to pay any fee now for taking admission in government pre-university, degree and PG courses. So it will benefit around 3.7 lakh students at a cost of 95 crore rupees. That is, it will put a load of 95 crore rupees on the state exchequer. There will be a Konkani study chair. It will be established at Karnataka University in Dharwad at a cost of 1 crore rupees. Then in the new financial year, total outlay is 4514. Now let's talk about health. So the biggest announcement was that Karnataka is not following the Modi care or Namo care, or they call it Ayushman Bharat scheme, that was announced in the budget by Arun Jaitley. Karnataka has said no. West Bengal has said no. They are starting their own universal health coverage, which is called Arogya Karnatake Yojane. Okay, Arogya Karnatake Yojane, universal health coverage. However, he did not delve into more details about this. He said details will be provided in the days to come, but this will provide the complete coverage. This is a universal health coverage scheme of Karnataka. Now, 9,000 health and wellness center will be set up by upgrading the existing sub-center for every 5,000 population in the rural area during the next 7 years. So at the basic level, you have a sub-center which caters to a population of 5,000 in the plain area and 3,000 in a hilly area. Then you have a primary health center which caters to a population of 20,000 in a hilly area and 30,000 in a plain area. And then you have a community health center, which is a amalgamation of four primary health center. So it caters to a area of population of 80,000 in the hilly area and 120,000 in a plain area. So remember that 9,000 health and wellness center will be created by upgrading the sub center. Is it clear? And the focus will be on the reproductive health, child health, etc. Because it is only in the sub center, primary health center and community health center, that the poor people go for the delivery. So institutional delivery will be given preference. And 571 center will be established during 2018-19. Now let's talk about Namma Bengaluru, right, which is the Bengaluru metro. But before that, let's talk about a suburban rail. So special purpose vehicle for suburban rail in Bengaluru will be set up. This project is worth 17,000 crore rupees, and this is done in collaboration with Ministry of Railways. Then there will be a new logistics policy. It will be announced to create a multimodal transportation network. Logistics park will be set up in 400 acres of land near Bengaluru and 50 acres near Hubballi. And metro phase 3, so it will be launched for 105 kilometers, and once completed, total metro will be 266 kilometers. Some other important announcement. So various development works will be taken up at Sangoli and Nandagadda at a budget of 267 crore rupees. Suchi Sambarama kits, they have been extended now to the post-matric hostel student. Enhancement of creamy layer income limit has been increased from 6 lakh to 8 lakh rupees so that more people can avail reservation for backward classes. Now, provision of 10 lakh rupee loan at only 6% for self-employment to unemployed backward class students will also be provided. There is a new scheme to provide loan and subsidy under the professional incentive scheme of Minority Development Corporation at a cost of 30 crore rupees. 200 crore rupee has been put aside for the development of the Christian community. Then for startups, there is a startup loan facility scheme for women at a cost of 15 crore through Minority Development Corporation. And there will be opening of 25 new Morarji Desai residential school. Morarji Desai, if you recall, was the ex-Prime Minister of India. He had taken over when the emergency had subsided in 1977. He became the Prime Minister because Jay Prakash Narayan, who was the architect of the anti-emergency movement, was not well. Then Karnataka also wants to do the skill development of the youth. So 120 government ITI, ITI means Industrial Training Institute, they will get computer lab facility at a cost of 10 crore rupees under the private public partnership model. 2.5 lakh people will be trained by the Department of Skill Development, Entrepreneurship and Livelihood. And Disha scheme will be extended to all the districts to train 1 lakh entrepreneurs at a cost of 2 crore rupees. Let's talk about inclusive society, what they are doing. So 250 urban Anganwadi will be set up at a cost of 17.5 crore rupees. 100 mobile Anganwadi and crèches to be set up at workplaces benefiting laborers at a cost of 10 crore. Loans under Udyogini scheme have been increased from 1 lakh rupee to 3 lakh rupees. And there will be 4% reservation in grade A and B jobs in Karnataka for the differently abled. There will be 300 crore rupees grant. There has been a 300 crore rupees grant for the development of Soliga, Junu Kuruba, Kudu Kuruba and other communities. Reservation of 25% of seats for backward classes and minority students in the SCST post-matric hostel. This is very, very important. Subsidy in the form of share capital for 100 eligible SCST cooperative societies. Loan and subsidy on priority to 600 manual scavenger identified in the rural and urban for land purchase. Also, to strengthen the reproductive and child health services, to reduce the infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate, special emphasis will be put in the next 7 years. Now, all the major district and taluka hospital shall be certified under NABH. NABH stands for National Accreditation Board for Hospitals and Healthcare Providers. And public accountability will be enhanced. Public accountability will be enhanced by displaying the number of outpatient, inpatient. So digital records will be done. And also, there will be a state health council that will be set up now to make sure that there is effective implementation of the very controversial Karnataka Private Medical Establishment Act, KPME Act. Mental health care program will be started because the government does not want to exclude mental health care. It is very important. And during 2018-19, a total amount of 6645 crore is provided to health and family welfare. Now, medical education. So, there will be 1000 bed additional ward in the Bengaluru Medical College and Research Institute. And medical education has got total of 2177 crore rupees. There will be construction of hospitals in medical colleges of Gadag, Kopal and Chamarajanagar at an estimated cost of 100 crore each. And for this, a grant of 90 crore will be provided during the next financial year. Now, there is a cardiovascular treatment facility that will be provided at a cost of 7.81 crore at Shimoga Super Speciality Hospital. Then PET, positron emission tomography, CT scan facility at Kidwai Cancer Institute in Bengaluru at a cost of 15 crore rupees. New building will be constructed at Nursing College Mysuru at a cost of 30 crore rupees. Cardiovascular treatment unit with cath lab facility at Bidar Medical Science Institute and Gadag Medical Science Institute at a cost of 15 crore each. Burns ward will be commenced at Kalaburgi Medical College. And cancer treatment unit will be established at an estimated cost of 15 crore each in Hassan, Mysuru and Karwar. Also, there will be nursing schools and colleges coming up under the medical education department and they will be upgraded at a cost of 30 crore rupees. So the total outlay is 2177 crore. Now remember that this one is the most important part of the video. So it is inter-caste marriages. Now, so the thing is that for eradication of untouchability, incentive amount will be increased from 2 lakh rupees to 3 lakh for a scheduled caste boy marrying a girl from another caste. And if a scheduled caste girl marries a boy, she will get 5 lakh rupees. Earlier, she used to get 3 lakh. So it has been increased from 3 lakh to 5 lakh. Also, there is an incentive of 5 lakh rupees for girl child of Devadasi and 3 lakh rupees for male child of Devadasi as marriage assistance that has been announced. For farmers, let's see something more. 845 crore rupees has been allocated for Karnataka Raitha Suraksha Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, which is basically agriculture crop insurance scheme. 600 crore for Krishi Bhagya scheme. 50 crore rupees has been for making the Karnataka organic. So 1.5 lakh hectare of land will be brought under organic farming. The only organic state in India right now is Sikkim. New agriculture college will be set up in Chamarajanagar. And 24 crore has been allotted to increase millet farming to 60,000 hectare. This is very important because 2018 is declared as the year of the millet. And Karnataka is the leading producer of coffee and millet in India. This is the most important scheme called Raita Belaku. It empowers the farmer with economic independence. So dry land farmer, and let me tell you that Karnataka, as in the words of Siddaramaiah, he said that Karnataka is the second driest land after Rajasthan. It has the maximum dry land in India after Rajasthan. So dry land farmer will get guaranteed annual income between 5,000 to 10,000 per hectare, and it will benefit 70 lakh dry land farmers. This is the biggest national program in terms of area covered, which is 64 lakh hectare, and also the number of farmers impacted, which is 70 lakh, 7 million farmer, and the amount is 3500 crore. Farm loan waiver scheme of up to 1 lakh rupee from cooperative banks after the death of the farmer. And Karnataka Sport University will be set up under the private-public partnership model. Something for Bengaluru. So the arterial road is basically a high-capacity urban road. So all the arterial and sub-arterial roads of Bengaluru will be white-topped over the next 5 years. 150 kilometers in the next financial year. And this is what you call a white-topping. So the roads are made up of your asphalt. Okay. So over asphalt, you put cement also. That is what you call white topping. And this prevents potholes also. So for example, 1 kilometer area between in the Hosur road between Ayappa temple and Madiwala has no potholes. Why? Because it was white topped in 2010. We are talking now in 2018. Still no potholes. But this is very, very costly. You know, the cost of white topping is almost double that of asphalting a road. So over asphalt, we put a layer of cement in white topping. Now, 40 lakhs will be developed in the next financial year, 2018-19. and Belandoru Lake will especially, you know, because it catches fire. 250 kilometers of footpath will be developed. 110 villages will be included in BBMP. They will be developed. 2500 crore rupees allocation for Bengaluru development. Moving on, farmers will be able to get a loan of 10 lakh rupees at only 3% interest. And to provide the debt relief to farmer affected by successive drought, there will be a loan waiver scheme with a total implication of 8,165 crore rupees benefiting almost 22 lakh farmers. This is very, very important. Government has also announced that it will set aside 794 for skill development and entrepreneurship. An agriculture research center will be set up in Vijaypur districts, Mudai Bihala, and Nanjuda Swami Research Chair at GKVK Bengaluru at a cost of 1 crore rupees. So 845 crore rupees is for Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Let's revise quickly. 600 crore for Krishi Bhagya, 50 crore for organic farming and new agriculture college at Chamrajnagar, and 24 crore for millet farming. 120 crore rupees has been allocated for maintenance of Indira Canteen under the BBMP's jurisdiction. Indira Canteen are where subsidized food is provided. 50 crore rupees has been allocated for rejuvenation of Belandur Lake. Now, 10 double-decker buses through Karnataka State Road Transport KSRTC between cities will be operated for the first time in the country, double-decker buses. Kalaburgi Kalavana, it will be constructed to reflect the art, culture and heritage of North Karnataka, Kalaburgi Kalavan. There will be comprehensive tourism development in Hampi, Beluru, Alabeddu, Shravanabelagola, Nandi Hills, Sannati and Kalaburgi Fort. There will be implementation of Madhyam Sanjeevani. Madhyam Sanjeevani, it is a group insurance scheme to all the journalists with an insurance coverage up to 5 lakh rupees in case of their untimely death or accident. Also, this is one of the most important, the excise duty on the foreign liquor has been increased by 8%. So from second slab has been put in the 18th slab. Now for the women fishermen, you can get a loan of 50,000 rupees at 0% interest. This is for women fishermen. 5.9 lakh government employees will get a 30% raise. This will put an extra load of 10,508 crore rupees on the exchequer. 7.5 crore rupees will be spent for modernization of 75 sheep and goat markets in the state. Total of 2377 crore is provided for animal husbandry. And just like Delhi Heart, we will have Mysuru Heart. This will be developed in Karnataka Exhibition Authority in Mysuru. There is also 247 crore rupees for Information Technology, BT, Science and Technology Department. And there will be a 3D planetarium that will be built in Belagavi at a cost of 3 crore rupees. So this was the comprehensive coverage of the budget. I hope you liked the video, enjoyed the video. This was what you call a make everyone happy budget. And I'm sure you all are happy. Thank you so much.